Namaste YouTube, welcome to CAFE ENOMA and welcome to our reaction to Neil Diamond. We are going to react to the song, I Am, I Said. It's a request of our patron Jeff. This is the first time single take on his reaction to this song. And if I'm not wrong, we are going to react to Neil Diamond singing for the first time.
Yeah, we've heard songs where he's been the songwriter. It comes across sometimes the songwriter's name is Neil Diamond. We've heard songs like that.
Yeah.
But I think it's the first time we are ever listening and reacting to him on ENOMA. Mm. And that's basically what we do. We listen as well as we react. Two main things. And for all the newcomers joining us from Laos in Cambodia or Bangkok in Thailand or all the way to Thimphu, our neighboring country, I hope you're having a good time here today on YouTube with us.
Yeah.
And welcome aboard. And the algorithm works in a way that we reach the West last. You wonder why we are taking these kind of names if you are from the West,
where Neil Diamond is. From New Orleans, or you are from Brooklyn.
If you are where Neil Diamond was huge or is huge,
yeah,
you'll wonder why we are taking such names as Thimphu, which you may not have heard of in your life. But that's where we go first, because we are based in the heart of Asia in Mumbai. We go first to the rest of Asia, then to Africa, then to Australia, then to Europe and US. Last. So by the time we actually reach the fans of Neil Diamond in US, unless they've subscribed and hit the bell icon, they will not get this video before you.
Yeah.
So we first pay respects to our newcomers from these parts of the world,
mm,
who probably are listening to this for the first time with us.
With us.
Because three songs in one video, the chances are very high they've not heard all three. And like us, we've not heard all of the three in this case.
Yeah.
Neil Diamond, I Am, I Said. And you can check out our Patreon page to learn more about us if you want to request a reaction or learn more about us. Neil Diamond, I Am, I Said. Let's get started.
LA's fine, the sun shines most of the time, and the feeling is laid back. Palm trees grow and rents are low, but you know, keep thinking about making my way back. Well, I'm New York City born and raised, but nowadays I'm lost between two shores. LA's fine, but it ain't home. New York's home, but it ain't mine no more. I am myself to no one there, and no one heard at all, not even the chair. I cried, I am, said I, and I am lost, and I can't even say why. Leaving me lonely still, did you ever read about a frog who dreamed of being a king and then became one? Well, except for the names and a few other changes, if you talk about me, the story's the same one. But I got an emptiness deep inside that I've tried, but it won't let me go. And I'm not a man who likes to swear, but I never cared for the sound of being alone. I am myself to no one there, and no one heard at all, not even the chair. I cried, said I. And I am lost and I can't even say why. I am myself.
This is quite dark and deep, you know, when you don't belong anymore, it's a bad feeling, it's a really sunken feeling, and I completely get that because it has happened to me on this platform, both of us, so I completely get most of what is sung here. Beautiful song, what a voice, what a voice. The music is just heavenly, simple but heavenly. It was just such a pleasurable experience listening to Neil Diamond today. Wow, this is a good song. This will go on to my playlist for personal reasons as well as for the music.
Yeah, I especially like the way he sang it, his voice, the way it was sung, the way it's written as well. Wow, the moment the song started and he said about LA and the sun is shining and the rent may be low, I said, is it? But when he talked about New York, I said, okay, that makes sense. That does make sense. When you compare it to New York, yes, the rent must be low. Pretty low for a person who's coming from New York. His emptiness, his feeling of loneliness, his longingness for his place, his home, is so deep, so painful to listen to through that voice. This is what we talk about when we talk about feelings. When we talk about the person feeling the song, he felt the song. He literally, the way he said, I am, I said, things like that, they felt he meant it. They feel like, actually, I was wondering during the song as well, is it a real thing that he experienced or is this something he wanted to capture?
It sounded real.
It sounds real.
Yeah, and from all those joining us from Ukraine and Romania and Bulgaria and Hungary as well as other countries in that part of the world, where Neil Diamond is pretty popular, I would imagine. I've heard about his songs in movies that I've watched at film festivals. Okay. So for all of you joining us today, tonight, I hope you're having a good time and I hope this song connected with you as it connected with me. And I'm sure you know what I'm talking about.
And all of you New York guys.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know why exactly it was the case with him as he sang it. But he probably knows best.
Yeah.
And yeah, you're right. Probably people from that part of the world, New York City or other cities in America may know what he's talking about.
Dave Matthews Band, I think, is from New York. They come from New York, hail from New York.
Actually, no, they come from somewhere else. We were corrected in the comments.
Okay, okay.
So he's very popular in New York, but I think he's from Seattle.
They are? Okay. That's unique. That's nice to hear. This is, you know, the agony, the feel, the pain of a person who's missing his home. He feels he may have got everything. He's like the frog who became the king and change a few things and it is my story. But still there is emptiness in me.
Yeah. That's it for this reaction video. Check out our Patreon page, especially if you're a newcomer from Romania, Bulgaria and the other countries I mentioned. Even if you're from France or New York City,
New
NYC.
York City. Yes.
Check out our Patreon page. Learn more about us. Check out our other reactions. And if you'd like to get all our reactions, there's only one way to do it, which is to subscribe and hit the bell icon. It's a different view that we get to the table from Mumbai, India.
Yeah.
A unique perspective by easygoing native outsiders making assessments. That's the full form of Enoma, by the way.
Yes.
If you look it up in our description box below, that's where our Patreon page link is too. So if you like that unique outsiders perspective on music that is requested for us to listen to, definitely you'll want to check out more of our reactions.
Yeah.
That's it for now.
Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our reaction to the song At 17. It's a request of our patron Jeff, and it's a song by Janice Ian. This is the first time reaction to it. We are going to listen to Janice Ian also for the first time.
Yeah, probably for the first time in my life too, even though I've heard more than 12,000 English songs and a whole lot of others in other languages. I think this is the first time I'm ever listening to Janice. I've heard of Janis Joplin and Janet Jackson, but not Janice Ian. So I'm looking forward to this, and to all the newcomers who are joining us from Mauritius, from Syria, from Iran, from Egypt, from Moldova, from Cote d'Ivoire, from Jamaica, and all different parts of the world, I hope you have a good time with us listening to these songs. And this one especially, it's the first time listen for both of us, and I'm sure most probably it is for you too. Mm-hmm. Let's get started with this reaction. These are for our patron Jeff. Yeah.
I learned the truth at 17, that love was meant for beauty queens and high school girls with clear skin smiles who married young and then retired. The Valentines I never knew, the Friday night charades of youth were spent on one more beautiful. At 17 I learned the truth. And those of us with ravaged faces, lacking in the social graces, desperately remained at home, inventing lovers on the phone, who called to say, come dance with me, and murmured faith obscenities. It isn't all it seems. It's 17. A brown-eyed girl in hand-me-downs, whose name I never could pronounce, said, pity please the ones who serve, they only get what they deserve. In the rich relation hometown queen marries into what she needs with a guarantee of company and haven for the elderly. Remember those who win the game, lose the love they sought to gain in Devonshire's of quality. Integrity. The small town eyes will gape at you in dull surprise when payment due exceeds accounts received. It's 17. To those of us who knew the pain of Valentines that never came, and those whose names were never called when choosing sides for basketball. It was long ago and far away, the world was younger than today, and dreams were all they gave for free to ugly duckling girls. We all play the game when we dare to cheat ourselves at solitaire, inventing lovers on the phone, repenting other lives unknown. They call and say, come dance with me, murmur vague obscenities at ugly girls like me.
relevant.
Love the music. I love her voice.
Yeah.
Nice, interesting to listen to. Really interesting, fascinating.
Yeah.
So fascinating song. Very deep lyrics too. And we'll talk about that a bit later if you have the time. What are your thoughts, Kirti, as a first time listener, pure yet a young listener from India? And what are your words about this song all the newcomers from all parts of the world?
These are connectable lines. The song is very, very, a song that resonates with a lot of people. Almost every one of us has gone through the age of 17. We have all gone through those phases in life. And all of us looking back, or someone who's in that phase at the moment, will connect to these lines. Sometimes some people are very, very lucky, blessed, that they don't feel that bad during those days. But that is the time most young people find something or the other very difficult to deal with. They're dealing with a lot of things, a lot of pressure, and a lot of things happening from inside as well. Their hormonal changes, the changes that are happening with them, the changes that they are dealing with at home, with parents not being able to cope up with them growing up so quickly. For parents, it is like, my child was a baby just now, and now it is he or she is a teenager. They didn't grow up with the children. They keep thinking they are protecting them, and they are protecting them. They don't keep up with the needs of the children. It's very difficult. So all of that wavelength changes. And your equations, your connections in the school, in the college, in the society, everything changing, as well as your physical growth and everything, it makes it a very challenging phase of life, adolescence. It's one of the most crucial times of the young days, apart from being a baby who, you know, up to 2 years, again, when the teenage times come, is the most crucial time of a person's life. I don't think anything else is as important as the teenage as well as the baby days in a person's life, in growth, in terms of growth. I like the way it was sung. I like the way it was written down as well. It felt like she was singing actually her own story. I'm not sure Janis Ian actually had those experiences, or is it a song just written about the topic. But the way she sang it, I like the flow of the song. It flows easily. On the first listen, I had no difficulties understanding her accent, the way the song was flowing, the way the music was constructed as well. Some horns came in towards the end of the song. Those keys were there along with the guitar coming in and going. It sounded very, very good.
And it is a beautiful song that will connect with millions of people world over, especially those at that age of 16 and 17 and even 18. It will connect with a lot of them, from Nigeria to Nepal, and from India to America. I think it will connect with millions and millions of people, this kind of song.
Yeah.
And it's sad that not many of us have heard this song ever in our lives, or this artist. So that's why we are here. We are here to create awareness in new markets for artists like this, who have written good songs like this. I'm not sure about other songs of this artist, but this was a great impression it made on me.
Mm-hmm.
And it goes for all those people in those age groups, as I said, the teen years, mid-teens and late teens, because they are often bullied, they are often cast out, they are often the ones whose names are not called for whatever reason, whether they are often the ones without prom dates, they are often the ones without Valentine's. So it goes to all of them who spend so many moments, so many times alone, you know, and feeling lonely and low. So this is a song that will resonate with millions and millions of kids in those specific age groups. So it's a beautiful song, beautiful song. And though many people on our channel are obviously adults and not kids, but definitely above the age of 16 in certain countries in the West. So it will go to all of them, and I hope they enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, it's a strong song. And that's it. It creates awareness about the mindset of a person at that age, this exact person, kind of person. And we need to acknowledge that, empathize with them, and, you know, accept them for who they are, not cast them out and not treat them badly or wrong, or not discriminate them based on all so many parameters, silly, silly parameters that we set up, from skin color to hair length and how they look and what they wear and shoes and the smartphone they carry even. It's silly. It's silly how we discriminate against people these days. And we need to stop that. And this song creates awareness about all those things. Very relevant even in today's world. The parameters will change, but the song's lyrics remain the same. And it's relevant and timeless. That's it for this one. We'll come back with another song in 8 seconds or less. Hope you're enjoying your time with us for Maldives and Mauritius. And I hope you're enjoying the weather there too.
Yeah.